Hey there. Have you ever heard of Warner Splatter? It's a parody featuring animated Warner characters, Tom and Jerry and Looney Tunes, dying in brutal ways. If you have seen by chance a picture of Jerry getting chopped off by Tom, it comes from that demented parody. Well, I had a terrible experience with something like that. First things first, let me introduce myself. Name's Susie, and I'm an anthropomorphic dinosaur. I used to be a bully, being mean to everyone, threatening others. But an indirect trip to another world changed me completely. That's not what I'm gonna talk about though. It was Saturday, and I was grounded for skipping class yesterday. Not that I cared a lot. I lied to my parents because if I told them the true reason why I skipped class, they wouldn't believe me. I was in my bedroom when our house phone rang. My dad picked it up, and Toriel was on the phone. She wanted me to go to school because I was with Chris when we were gone for a long time. When I went there, Toriel was really pissed off.
Mind you explain me what did you do with Chris yesterday?
Asked Toriel. Miss Toriel, I promise, I didn't do anything to them. Well, I might have threatened them, but nothing more, nothing less. I answered. Then I told her the real reason of our disappearance. Unfortunately, that made her more pissed off.
Are you f***ing out of your mind?
She screamed. I was shocked. Toriel had never swore, not even in front of a student.
I can't believe you have been doing drugs. That's illegal and wrong.
She kept screaming. I swear I didn't do drugs. I said.
Well, if you are gonna keep lying, then I will have to get rough.
She said, as she dragged me to the detention room. She made me sit and then pulled out a disc with the title, Carnage, drawn in red marker.
This will teach you to not be a terrible monster.
She said, as she inserted the disc in the DVD player and left the room. The movie started with the modern intro of Disney movies. Then the Pixar intro appeared, but when the lamp squashed the eye, the screen went black, followed by a disturbing sound. Then it went back, but the lamp was covered in blood. What? This was shocking. They had never shown blood in a Pixar or Disney movie as far as I was concerned. Must have been a prank to scare me off. After that, the Steamboat Willie intro began playing, but when it was about to end, Pete appeared on the edge of the river, throwing rocks at him, which didn't do much damage. What went next horrified me. Pete lifted a big boulder and threw it at the steamboat, exploding it and sending Mickey's limbs flying everywhere, while he laughed. This shocked me. Pete was a bad guy, why wouldn't he attempt murder? Finally, the movie began with Captain Hook from Peter Pan running from the TikTok croc, but the crocodile managed to catch him, and began eating him limb by limb, while blood and organs sprouted everywhere. This made me really sick. I wanted to get out of there, but the door was locked, so the only thing that I could do is watch this monstrosity. After that, we see Gaston from Beauty and the Beast stabbing the Beast, and then he's thrown into the cliff, where his body is ripped in half after hitting a Sharpie rock. Then the movie cuts to the final battle of Syndrome from The Incredibles. He was trying to get out of the turbine that was getting sucked into, but unfortunately, he gets sucked and shredded. The movie changed to the near end of The Hunchback of Notre Dame, where Frollo gets into a gargoyle and falls into the fire, while his skin gets burnt, only to splatter onto the floor later. This was sickening. How did Toriel have access to it? Did she made it? Did she bought it on the dark web? It changed to the finale of the Tarzan movie. Clayton was falling, trying to get rid of the vines, but instead of getting hanged, the pressure of the vines decapitated him. Tarzan approached the corpse, ripped out his heart, ate it and began beating his own chest, crying. The next scene was from The Lion King. Scar was getting surrounded by his former followers, and then he got eaten out by them. This of course was uncensored, and I could see how they ripped him apart limb by limb, piece by piece, until the only thing left of him were his bones. The next thing was the death of Hopper, from A Bug's Life. I just saw him getting graphically pecked by the birds. God, I wanted to end this suffering already. We then suddenly see a scene of Randall from Monsters, Inc. falling, and when he hit the ground, blood and guts splattered everywhere. I tried to turn this off, but it wouldn't shut down. It's like it was meant to torture me. This wasn't a punishment anymore. After an hour of agony, the movie ended, without any credits. I went into the TV and tried to throw it into the window when, all of a sudden, Alfie's opened the door and walked in, clapping her hands sarcastically.
Good job, Susie. I hope you learned your lesson.
She said. She then began explaining that her and some students made a fan parody video of several Pixar and Disney movie scenes, as a punishment method. Well, what can I say? It worked. Remember, never act like a bad person, or else you might get mental scars for the rest of your life, like me.